Something back to you, he'll give you more than what he gave you on the last time. Amen. Amen. And so if you will, turn your Bibles to the book of Genesis, the 11th chapter. Amen. The 27th through the 32nd verse. Amen. Amen.
If you have it, say amen.
Genesis 11, 27 through the 32nd verse, and we'll skip down to Genesis 12 and 4. Amen. Do you have it? I will. Amen. And the Bible declares, now these are the generations of Terah. Terah begat Abram, Nahor, and Haran. And Haran begat Lot. And Haran died before his father Terah in the land of his nativity, in Ur of the Chaldeans. And Abram and Nahor took them wives. The name of Abram's wife was Sarai, and the name of Nahor's wife, Milcah, the daughter of Haran, the father of Milcah, and the father of Iscah. But Sarah, or Sarah, was barren. She had no child. And Terah took Abram his son, and Lot the son of Haran, his son's son, and Sarah, his daughter-in-law, his son, Abram's wife, and they went forth with them from Ur of the Chaldees to go into the land of Canaan. They were supposed to go to Canaan. Just tell somebody, they were supposed to go to Canaan. And they came unto Haran and dwelt there. They were supposed to go to Canaan, but they stopped in Haran. And the Bible says, and the days of Terah were 205 years. And Terah died in Haran. Skip down to chapter number 12, verse number 4, and the Bible records these words. So Abram departed as the Lord had spoken unto him. He told his daddy that you were supposed to go to Canaan, but his daddy died in the place that he dwelt. So God begins to speak to Abram. And the Bible says, so Abram departed, and the Lord had spoken to him. And Lot went with him. And Abram was 75 years old when he departed out of Haran. If you will, just look over at somebody, grab them by the hand and say, neighbor, God is getting ready to take us from our dry place to our wealthy place. Come on, just look across the room and say, neighbor, God is getting ready to take you from a dry place to a wealthy place. Come on, if you believe that, clap those hands and give God the glory. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. The book of Genesis is attributed to the authorship of Moses and was revealed to him on Mount Sinai. Genesis is the first book of the Bible and that of the Old Testament. The book of Genesis is full of prophecies concerning the Lord Jesus Christ. Genesis begins with the creation of the world. The Bible declares in Genesis 1 and 1, in the beginning God created the heavens and the earth. Not only does Genesis begin with creation, but the book of Genesis, it means the beginning. Just tell somebody Genesis means the beginning. Understand that the book of Genesis, it suggests to us that everything has a beginning. Before man became a living soul, he was dust of the ground. That was his beginning. Before there was ever an Abraham, he was Abram. Before he became the father of faith, he was Abram. Before his name was changed, he was Abram. Before he was the father of many nations, he was Abram. And just like Abram, people of God, many of us, we have a beginning. And if truth be told, we can all testify this morning that we didn't get to where we are overnight. Not only does everything have a beginning, but everything has been through a process, my God. And because we are still here, my God, we are going through a process because there is an expected end that God has for us. The Bible declares in Jeremiah 29 and 11, the Bible declares, for I know the thoughts that I think toward you, saith the Lord. Thoughts of peace and not of evil, but to give you an expected end. And because you are here this morning, people of God, God has an expected end for your life, my God. Because you made it this morning to Queen Memorial Church of God in Christ, you are still in the process of God making you, my God. You are still in the process of God molding you. You are still in the process of God shaping you. That's why the Bible says that he is the potter and we are the clay. And it is our prayer should be to make us and mold us after thine own way, my God. So while we're still here, God is taking us through a process. Why, Mother? Because there is a place that God wants to get you, my God. And you have not arrived to that place yet, but you're still going through the process. Just encourage yourself this morning and tell yourself, I'm still going through the process, my God. And I found out, people of God, even though I'm going through the process and I'm not where I want to be, my God, I'm so glad I'm not where I used to be, my God. Is there anybody in here this morning that you're glad that you're not where you used to be, my God? But as I look back over my life, my God, and see where God brought me from, my God, my hands sometimes just go up, my mouth open up and give them praise, my feet go to dancing, sometimes I go to leaping, because I know where God has brought me from, my God. The songwriter said, you don't know my story, my God, or the things that I've been through. You can't even feel my pain, or what I had to go through to get here. But tell somebody, and you'll never understand my praise. So don't even try to figure it out, because when I praise him, it's because I look back over my life and see where God has brought me from. When I praise him, it's because God
A reason why I praise him is because God showed me that Willie, you're still in the process. But while you're in the process, don't look back from where I brought you from. But keep on moving. Just encourage somebody this morning and tell them you're just going through the process. Yeah, it's important you go through the process. It's important you go through the things that you're going through. Because if you didn't go through it, my God. If you didn't go through it, my sister and my brother, you'll never know the God that you serve. You'll never know that God is able. You'll never know God to be just who he said he is.
So this morning, I want to take a look at Abram's beginning. Can I just take a look? Can we just take a look at Abram's beginning? Watch this. The Bible says, if you go back in the scriptures, the Bible says that Abram, his daddy name was Terah. And the Bible says that God gives him charge. He gives him some instructions. He gives him some things to follow. And can we stop right there this morning? And can I tell you, when God gives you an objective, when he gives you instructions, it is important that you follow those instructions, because you never know what God is trying to take you. You never know what God is trying to do in your life. So it is very important, it is imperative that we listen to the voice of God. And so the Bible says, as we read it, the Bible says that his father Terah, he takes him, his family, he takes his sons Haran, he takes his son Abram, he takes his wife, he takes his son's wife, he takes his other son's wife, and they leave the place where they were. That's a good thing. We can stop right there. Yes, some of you were in a place that God didn't want you to be, and when God told you to get up, you got up and left. But can I tell you, can I stop here and tell you, don't get like their daddy. God told him, I need you to go to Canaan, but he stopped in Haran. And many of us, we get comfortable in this walk of salvation. God has brought us from a mighty long way, and in the midst, in the middle of our journey, we stop. Why? Because we got comfortable. We think we arrived, but can I tell you this morning, you ain't arrived, baby. God still got work for you to do. God still is trying to take you somewhere. Yeah, and you can't stop when God is moving. You can't stop, my God. The Bible said that he was a cloud by day and a pillar of fire by night. And the people of God have to follow him. Well, he had to follow the cloud. They had to follow the fire, because God was trying to bring them out of bondage, my God. And so the Bible says that this father, he takes his whole family and he brings them to Haran. It reminds me of a man named Eli Melek. If you know Eli Melek, the Bible says in the book of Ruth, the first chapter, that Eli Melek, he took his family to Moab. Watch this. They leave Bethlehem, Judah, which is the house of blessings, my God. And the Bible says, because there was a famine in the land, he takes his family and travels to Moab. But the Bible says, it uses this word, they were supposed to sojourn to Moab, which means that after the famine was over, they were supposed to go back to the house of blessings. But just like I said, we get so comfortable in the things, my God. We get so content and so complacent, my God. We forget God, my God. Yeah, I believe that was what the Sunday school was kind of talking about this morning. We forget God when God has done some things for us. God made a way for Eli Melek and his family. He said, if you go to Moab, there'll be some food there for you to eat. And you got to understand something about Moab. Moab is a pagan land. And the Bible said that they dwelt in Moab. And the Bible says, watch this, that the sons begin to marry women in Moab. They begin to marry women that didn't think as they thought. They begin to marry women that believe that they didn't believe. And so the Bible says, not only did Eli Melek die in Moab, but the Bible says that his sons died in Moab. And so you gotta understand, people of God, when God gives you a charge, it is important that you follow the instructions of God, because you don't want to die in the place he told you to get up and leave from. He told you to leave that man
Haran. I'm back in the text. And so the Bible said he goes to Haran. Watch this. Haran means the parched place or the dry place, my God. And it means that this place had the inability to produce, my God. And so for my first point this morning, can I tell you, people of God, that it is important that you are not under the influence of people that will lead you into dry places, my God. Yeah, you gotta be careful, my God, that you are not under the influence or the leadership of people that will lead you into dry places, my God. But wherever God has brought you out of, just tell somebody to stay out, my God. If God brought you out of the crack house, you might as well stay out. If God has brought you out of a horrible pit, tell somebody, don't go back. If God has brought you out of the gutter, don't go back. If God has brought you out of a dark place, just tell your neighbor this morning, I can't afford to go back. Yeah, yeah, I can't afford to go back to my dry place. Because in a dry place, I got the ability to die in my dry place. Why? Because I'm not getting what I need. I found out, people of God, scientific studies show that you can only go so long without water. And then your inside begin to get dry. And so you need to tell me that he was in this place. And watch this. They were in Haran, my God, for over 60 years. Which lets me know that they were in a dry place. A place that couldn't produce anything, my God, for 60 years. And you gotta be careful that you don't get stuck in a dry place for so long that you end up dying. Because the Bible says that Terah, he died in the place he took his family. Let me keep on going. And watch this, people of God. The Bible declares that Abram's father took him and his wife. And you gotta understand something. Go back and read it. The Bible says that Abram's wife, her name was Sarai. And the Bible goes on to say that she was barren, which lets me know that Abram's situation, it gets worse before it gets better. Not only did his daddy take him to a dry place, but the text says his brother name was Haran, which means that his brother was dry. And most of all, watch this, and most of all, his wife was barren, which means she herself had the inability to produce because her insides were dry. Have you ever been a place in your life or connected to somebody that instead of things getting better, it only gets worse, my God? So you mean to tell me the Bible says that Haran, or excuse me, Abram, not only was he connected to some people who were dry, but his daddy takes him to a place that was dry and couldn't have the ability to produce, my God. It reminds me of Job. The Bible declares that the enemy sought after Job. The Bible says that the enemy, he had a conversation with God. And the conversation went something like this. God, if you let me touch him, he'll forsake you. If you let me just get a hold of him, he'll turn his back on you. And the Bible says that God, he permits the enemy to touch his servant Job. But you gotta understand something. Before Job's situation gets better, the Bible says it gets worse. Not only did he take away everything that he had, he killed his kids, took his money, took his cattle. The Bible says that now the enemy, he begins to attack Job, my God. But I've come to let you know this morning that God is getting ready to pull you out of your dry place, my God. That you can't stay in your dry place any longer. You cannot stay where God has been for you to come out of. If you read the Bible said there was a man named Lazarus. And the Bible said that he was dead already for 2 days. Let me stop and tell you, it was 2 days too long, my God. And some of you have been in a place far too long. But I come to let you know this morning that you're coming out. Well, you just grab your about the hand this morning and let them know that God, it's getting ready to you out. That God is getting ready to snatch you out of your dry place. Is there anybody in here that needs God to pull them out? I tell you just to pull your own self out and just keep on moving.
Watch this. The Bible goes on to say, not only does Abram, brother Haran, die, watch this. What the Bible says, before his daddy died, his brother died. But can I tell you the significance behind their death is this, that it was confirmation that God wanted Abram to go to Canaan and not his family, my God. That's why the Bible says that you gotta sometimes forsake your mama, your daddy, your sisters, your brothers, and follow him. The Bible says that if you forsake him, he'll give it back to you 100-fold. And the reason why God had to let them die where they were, because the promise was connected to Abram, my God. Just tell somebody there's a promise that's connected to my life. And if anybody is in my life that's not supposed to be there, God is getting ready to remove them. I tell you just to shout this morning and tell God, remove them out of my life. God, take them out of my life. God, bring me out. Separate me. That's why the Bible says, you because sometimes they're not going to come from you, my God. They're not going to come out from you. And so you, my God, have to come out from among them and be the separate, said the Lord, and touch not the unclean thing, because anything that you touch that is deadly, you don't die, my God. Just tell somebody, I can't die. I'm too close to what he got for me. I'm too close to my miracle. I'm too close to my promise. Just grab somebody again. Watch this, my God. Aren't you glad this morning, people of God, that God brought you out of dry conditions and situations in your life, my God? Here's point number three, that God had to move you out of a dry place to a place that was flowing, my God. Canaan, watch this. Canaan means the land of purple. Watch this. It is significant because this is the place that they produce, my God, and manufactured the finest purple dye, which lets me know that Canaan, my God, was a wealthy place, my God. Yeah, Canaan was the place where they manufactured the finest purple dye. And if you know anything about purple, it represents royalty, my God. And that's the place that God was trying to get Abram. He was trying to get him out of a dry place to a place that was familiar or connected to his destiny. Yeah, that's the place God is trying to get you out of and bring you to a place that can agree with your future, that can agree with your destiny, that can agree to the place that God has for you. Because you got to understand, when you do your research down the line and you study your Bible, you will understand that Canaan, it was the place that God had chosen for his people, my God. You got to understand that he was supposed to be the father of many nations, which lets me know not only was his promise in Canaan, but somebody else's promise was in Canaan. I dare you to grab somebody and to let them know that your promise may be connected to me. So you better watch how you treat me, because you don't know. You don't know what I got on me. Just tell somebody, I got an anointing. I got favor on my life. I dare you to rub shoulders with somebody and tell them, out of here. Watch this, people of God. Watch this. Here's the point number four. That God removed him from a place that couldn't produce anything to a place that could produce everything, my God. I dare somebody just to repeat that. That God removed him from a place that couldn't produce anything to a place that produces everything. And when God moves you out of your dry place, and when people are connected to you who have the inability
would have stayed there and not listened to the voice of God, his wife would have never gave birth to their child. That's why you gotta move when God says move, because you don't know what's coming out of your loins. You don't know what you got on the inside of you until you get out of the place that you were once in.
Yeah.
Shit.